多謝 WordPress.com， 即係 WordPress webcam 即係邀請我哋嚟啦。咁我係阿威啦，咁我今日就開始個 talk 啦。咁首先我好快咁介紹我先啦。咁我咧就係 Sky 嘅一個 pre-sales 啦，咁即係會負責 technical 嗰邊嘅多啲嘅方面嘅工作啦。咁就我哋 Sky 可能大家都聽過㗎啦，即係一分鐘介紹咧就係我哋一間香港嘅 local 嘅 developer 啦。咁我哋而家即係2008年成立，去到今時今日咧都已經係14、15年㗎啦。咁就我哋而家咧都有70個同事啦，喺香港、英國、台灣。咁我哋主要做嘅工作咧就係好多 custom 嘅 development 啦，但我哋都有自己嘅 product。所以今日我都係希望趁呢個機會咧，就同大家介紹下我哋其中一個 product 咧，就係 Authentication， 就係可以 integrate 落去 WordPress 嗰度咧，就做一個 authentication 嘅。咁你都見到啦，有幾隻貓咧，其實都係我哋公司養嘅貓嚟嘅，我哋公司都喺荔枝角嗰邊嘅啫，其實係。咁就希望如果有機會嘅話咧，大家有機會上嚟我哋 office 可以即係玩下貓，再同我哋傾下其他嘢啦，咁樣。好，咁事不宜遲，開始個正題啦。咁首先 WordPress 咧就頭先主持都講咗啦，其實我哋而家 WordPress 現有嘅 login 咧，可能大家如果有用過咧，簡單嘅 email password 啦。咁但係咧，其實當大家個網站唔係淨係做一個 blog 咁簡單，因為我相信今日都會好多人可能講到，其實 WordPress 佢絕對唔係淨係可以做網站，可以做到好多好多其他大型嘅網站。咁呢度咧有兩個例子啦，一咧就係由左手邊嗰個咧 ecom 嘅一個網站嘅例子嚟啫。但大家可以諗，如果有 ecommerce 嘅網站咧，係涉及到好多交易啦，可能啲人買嘢嘅資料啦等等。咁可能我哋對於 security 嘅要求咧，就可能唔會淨係滿足於最簡單嘅 email password 啦。另一邊啊，就係一個 membership 嘅 password。嘅網站這個呢個係我啱 cap 過嚟咧，就係 New Yorker。咁我睇翻咧，原來好多大型嘅網站，例如呢個 New Yorker， 即係嗰個雜誌嘅網站，都係用 WordPress 嘅。咁但係我想一個咁大型嘅網站，可能講成千上萬嘅 user， 咁我哋又係咪覺得 WordPress 嘅 user management 可以用 WordPress 嚟做個 user authentication 咧？咁之後咧就睇睇我哋而家 default WordPress 嘅 user management 啦。咁如果大家用過嘅話咧，都會見到其實佢有個簡單嘅界面啦，可以俾你 manage 到啲有見到唔同嘅 user 啦，睇翻啲 profile， 用 email password login。咁但係正如頭先講啦，當大家咧係而家好多現時大家諗覺得好自然要有嘅 off 嘅嘢，例如我要 social sign on 喎，咁我梗係要 link Google 啊 ，link Facebook， 咁我令到啲人容易啲 on board 啦。咁你就要裝個 plugin 啦，係咪？咁又或者咧我覺得 password OK。但是我想有 2FA 喎，因為可能我做啲買嘢嘅過程咧，我係覺得佢需要有即係 2-step 嘅，淨係 password 啊唔夠，咁我想加 2FA， 咁我又要整多個 plugin 喎可能。咁之後又或者咧，可能我 password 都 OK， 但係咧如果我哋一啲公司要用，可能咧我又需要有一啲password policy 嘅，即係話原來佢咧每隔幾耐要改一次 password 啦，或者 password minimum 嘅長度等等等等，呢啲加加下咧，其實如果大家想用 WordPress 去做曬咁多嘅 feature， 咁多security 嘅嘢咧。咁可能你家就會裝咗好多唔同嘅 plugin 噶啦。咁呢個係一個方法嚟嘅，係 work 嘅可能都。咁但係咧，今日我同大家介紹嘅咧係一個另外一個方法啦。咁呢度咧就係講緊integrate 我哋一個叫做 Authentication， 又或者其實咧 Authentication 咧我都冇太過賣廣告啦，都只係一個例子嚟嘅啫。其實而家咧都有好多唔同嘅 identity provider 咧，佢都係可以咧係support 呢一種 integrate 嘅方法嘅。咁我就用咗我哋公司嘅產品 Authentication 做例子啦。咁啊呢個 Authentication 咧其實本身咧。佢就已經可以 support 到好多唔同嘅大家覺得都必須要有嘅 security 功能嘅啦。例如頭先講啦 ，single sign on 咧就係除咗 social 嘅 sign on 之外咧，可能佢係用一個 account sign in 咗一個網站，例如 WordPress 啦，我有其他 app， 咁可能我都要唔需要佢再打密碼啦。password 咧呢個就好重要啦，因為咧好多時候咧，大家見到 security 會出現問題咧，就係、是、一方面咧就係佢哋可能啲人都會重用啲密碼啦，或者因為佢哋要唔同嘅網站記密碼好麻煩。或者我哋咧頭先都可能有啲自打嘴巴啦，或者我哋 set 咗啲好複雜嘅 password rules 啊，唔該你可能三個月半年要改一次，或者咧第二個密碼咧最少要有數字、英文字、大寫、細寫、符號咁樣，咁咧搞到咁多複雜嘅嘢咧，個 user 可能就會用一啲好簡單或者重用密碼，咁所以 passwordless login 咧就可以令到佢唔需要密碼都可以好 secure 咁 login 啦，咁得人可以 show 俾大家睇啦。咁之後另外咧就仲有 multi-factor 啦，頭先講咗，同埋 zero trust 咧呢個純粹概念都想介紹俾大家睇咧。就係、是、當我哋用咗呢啲咁嘅 service 之後咧，其實我哋個 WordPress 咧就唔再需要咧去儲存咗個 user 嘅嗰啲 authentication 嘅密碼嗰啲嘢噶。儘管 WordPress 咧，佢當然都係幾 secure， 佢都有定期嘅 bug fix 啊、security fix 等等啦。咁但係咧 ，zero trust 嘅概念就係我會將成個 user authentication 呢個部分咧，就喺我嘅 system 嗰度抽咗出嚟。我係個 user 咧，佢唔需要擔心我整呢個 WordPress 自己 host 一個網站。 究竟有冇啲 security issue 啦，有冇 apply 到最 latest 嘅 bug fix， 或者我嘅 server 冇俾人 hack 到，唔需要擔心噶啦，因為咧我已經將我個 off 嗰個功能咧就判咗俾 off gear 或者其他啲咁嘅 service， 咁就可以做到咧，就算我個 system 係真係有咩三長兩短有咩事咧，都唔會影響到 user， 我唔需要同大家講話，喂你我哋 system 咧俾人 hack 咗，你要改曬啲密碼啊等等等等。好，咁講咁多嘢咧，我其實就直接就會今日比較 hands on 啲咧，想 show 啲 demo 俾大家睇多啲嘅。咁就等等啊。好，咁咧大家見到呢度咧就是、一個好簡單嘅 WordPress 嘅網站模擬出嚟㗎啦。咁當我哋咧就撳個 login 嘅時候咧，咁就可以即係大家見到平時 login 嘅樣啦。咁呢度咧我就加咗一個咧就係、是、用 connect to 呢個 Office 嘅。咁撳完呢個之後咧。咁佢就會叫我 login 啦。咁呢度我想 demo 俾大家睇咧，就係我用一個 passwordless 嘅 login 嚟嘅。咁就係、是、我打個電話落去啦。咁之後咧，佢叫我咧就打個WhatsApp 嗰個號碼喎，唔好意思啊。咁咧就我咧其實咧就喺佢咧就會背後咧就會 send 咗個WhatsApp 個 off code 俾我嘅。我等等啊，等等先，41178。咁就佢哋 send 咗 WhatsApp 俾我，咁我就login。咁個 WhatsApp 係咩樣嘅咧？我都因為大家睇唔到，都 show 俾大家睇啦。咁其實即係簡單一個WhatsApp 嘅 message 啦。咁大家見到呢度咧，即係有個佢有個 code 俾我，就好似SMS 咁樣嘅。OK， 咁之後咧就入咗去啦。咁我而家係一個 login 咗嘅概念啦。咁呢度咧有咩好處咧？變咗咧，我哋係 user 係唔需要記咗密碼啦。第二咧就係、是、大家諗下，我哋用 WhatsApp login 喎，咁即係我有咗佢號碼、電話號碼喎。咁喺大家將來做一啲其他 marketing 啊、一啲 integration 嘅時候咧，就會好方便啦，因為你已經有咗個 user 嘅電話啦。同埋咧，頭先我都 show 俾大家咧，其實我係 send 咗個 WhatsApp 嘅 message 俾個客，佢已經收到個 OTP 噶嘛。咁即係話咧，如果大家有用過 WhatsApp 嘅話咧，我哋其實如果同 WhatsApp 想 send 啲 marketing 啊，想 send 啲 message 俾個 user 咧，其實要計錢噶嘛，因為佢可能逐個 session 咁樣就十幾個鐘頭內。就可以第一次免費。咁你用頭先嗰個 OTP 嗰個 message 其實已經同佢 start 咗個 conversation 㗎啦。咁你就可以好容易咧做其他 integration 咧，就 follow up 嚟之後嘅一啲 further 嘅 message， 即係去聽下佢話啊，你做咗啲咩未啊，或者有啲優惠啊等等俾佢。咁呢個咧就係、是、我用一個 WhatsApp login 嘅示範啦。咁之後咧就、想 show 俾大家睇，咁究竟點樣可以做到呢一個 integration 咧？咁就翻去頭先嗰度啦。咁其實咧就好簡單嘅啫。咁咧嗱，呢度咧就係一個WordPress 嘅 admin portal 啦。咁我呢度咧其實就裝咗，只係需要一個 plugin 咧，因為我哋呢一個 integration 就係用 WordPress 去用 off gear 或者其他 off 嘅 provider 嘅呢個 standard 咧，我哋叫做即係 OIDC 啦，就 Open ID Connect。咁咧市面上其實好多 plugin 嘅，咁我就是但攞咗呢個嚟做例子啦。咁喺呢個我裝完呢個 plugin 之後咧，我要 set 嘅嘢咧。咁其實第一咧就係、是、佢通常咧可以俾你揀啦，就係話啊，頭先大家見到我係喺 login 掣嗰度咧，我就有個 login page 有個掣俾佢撳咁樣啦。咁又或者你唔想俾佢撳嘅，我已經想佢直接咧就要用嗰個 off gear 都可以啦。咁之後咧就有其他 set up 嘅，咁呢啲 set up 咧就可以喺嗰個 off gear 嗰度咧。咁其實呢個都好通用於其他嘅 off 嘅 solution 咧。咁就會見到佢會俾一堆即係啲 client ID 啊、一啲 secret 啊、一啲 endpoints 你咧，咁就照翻佢要求你嘅嘢。照 copy and paste 落去咧，咁就搞掂咗噶啦，咁樣咁就會搞掂咗，就即係話 connect 咗噶啦。咁之後咧，另一樣嘢可能大家會自然問到，咦？咁、那個 user 即係喺邊啊？即係話咁我 WordPress 究竟有冇個 user 定係 off gear 有個 user 咧？咁呢度大家可以睇翻咧，其實咧，當我哋 connect 咗 off gear 之後咧，用 off gear login 去呢個 WordPress 嘅話咧。其實咧，佢自動咧就會喺嗰個 WordPress 嗰度咧就 create 翻相應嘅 user 嘅。呢個咧都係個 OIDC 對 login 比較特別啲嘅地方啦。呢個等陣可以我再講多少少。咁但係咧，去到嗰度之前咧，咁我想 show 一 show。咦，頭先我就淨係 show 咗用WhatsApp login 啦。咁其實而家 authentication 有好多方法噶嘛。咁所以咧，都希望喺呢個機會咧，就係即係話俾大家睇，其實究竟有啲咩 option 可以用啦咁樣。咁首先咧，有幾樣嘢嘅，咁最基本咧就係、是、email password 就唔使講啦。咁之後咧，我哋亦都可以用 mobile，mobile 咧就頭先舉例，我可以用 WhatsApp mobile 啦，或者用 SMS mobile。 咁大家話諗 mobile 咧有咩好處呢？用 mobile 除咗我可以攞到嗰個 user 嘅電話之外，呢度大家見唔見到下低咧？我哋可以有個 country code 嘅filter 揀啊。咁呢個用處咧，就係我可以透過呢個方法嚟咧，確保我嘅 user 咧，啊，原來我淨係想 support 香港嘅，或者我想 support 某個地區嘅，咁我就可以透過佢。當然啦，所有嘢咧都絕對冇得百分百限制嘅，只不過我哋喺我哋覺得個 UX 可接受之內，即係你要搞到啲 user 太麻煩都冇意思啦。我哋喺 UX 可接受嘅範圍之內咧，我哋例如我哋用呢個電話嘅 filter 啦，咁我哋就可以 make sure 啊，原來佢如果唔 support 嗰個號碼 country code 咧，我就唔俾佢 log in 啦，或者唔俾佢 create account， 咁就做啲 filtering 啦。咁之後咧，另外我哋都可以咧有嗰啲叫做account log out policy 啦。呢個都係一個我頭先提過嘅 security 好重要概念嚟嘅。咁我哋如果你喺 WordPress 嗰度，佢哋 user email password， 你咧就想佢即係有啲 rate limit 嘅，即係話如果佢亂進，有人亂咁撞密碼太多次要 block 佢 account 啊 ，lock 佢 account 咁樣咧，咁呢個 WordPress 當然就可能要揾啲 plugin 去搞啦。咁喺呢啲咁嘅 off 嘅 solution 裏面咧，咁通常已經會直接咧就會有一啲 lock out policy 可以俾大家 set 啦。咁例如呢度就話你失敗咗幾多次就會停你幾耐啦。咁或者係又或者咧 email 啦、password 啦。OTP 啦，呢啲都可以做到類似嘅方法嘅咁樣。咁之後咧，頭先講咗啦 ，email password 嗰啲咧就唔需要特別多講啦。咁但係當然基本嘅 password policy 呢度都係會有啦。我哋可以 set 翻佢嘅 minimum length 啦，或者其他要求，幾時改密碼等等。咁之後咧咁呢個social sign on 啦，咁亦都可以一次過咧，就喺我哋呢一個 platform 嗰度咧，就駁曬所有需要 connect 嘅即係啲 social sign on 嗰啲嘢嘅，即係例如咩 Google 啊、Facebook 等等等等。咁就另外啦 ，show 埋俾大家睇咧，就係 2FA 啦。咁 2FA 都係一個好重要嘅功能啦，因為當你個 user log in 嘅時候咧，你係想佢係有多重嘅認證。咁咧，我哋而家大家生活上常用噶啦，即係話用嗰啲叫做SMS 又得啦，又或者咧可以用我哋叫做 TOTP 啦，即係大家咧有時會裝嗰個 Authentication 咧，就話你咧要喺個手機度再開個 app， 之後有個號碼再打入去。咁呢個咧就睇大家嘅設計係點啦。因為咧，如果大家對象可能有啲比較 non-tech 嘅人咧，想個 user flow 係再順啲咧，其實呢個就未必太過 user friendly 嘅，因為佢仲要再裝個 app。所以通常咧，我哋建議咧，如果你話要有 2FA 嘅話咧，可能你係password 啦。再加頭先我講嗰啲 SMS 啊或者 WhatsApp 嘅即係 OTP 都可以嘅咁樣。咁之後咧，仲有另一個都好重要噶啦，就係咁我哋當我哋做一個 product 出嚟，我哋梗係想我哋有個 consistent 嘅 UI experience 俾個客啦。咁所以通常我哋嘅 solution 或者好多 solution 咧，其實都一定咧係會要 support 到咧係一啲 custom 嘅 UI 嘅 UI 嘅 customization 啦。咁大家見到咧，我哋就可以 set 翻曬所有嘅style 啦、顏色啦等等，咁就可以配合翻咧你原本嗰個 website 咧嗰個樣，咁就令到個 user 咧係會有 consistent 嘅 experience 啦。咁同埋咧，另一個我覺得都好重要嘅咧，就係當我哋咧即係個 application 我哋係一路發展，可能我哋會落咗好多 tracking 啦，或者可能我哋 user 咧越嚟越多唔同嘅功能，又或者我哋 integrate 其他 app 咧，其實我哋都需要儲低好多 user 嘅資料嘅。咁如果喺用翻傳統，淨係喺用曬個 WordPress 嚟做呢個 management 咧，咁就會好局限咗 WordPress 個 user 裏面俾你做嘅 profile 啦。咁喺我哋呢啲平台咧，咁我哋亦都可以好靈活咁樣咧，係可以 set 到個 user 咧可以有一啲我哋 default 就有一堆嘅 attribute 可以 set 啦。咁之後咧，我哋亦都可以 set 啲叫做 custom attributes 啦。咁我哋就係可以自己定義翻佢咧係個 attribute 嘅名啦。咁之後咧就可以揀翻係啲咩類型嘅嘢。咁我哋就加上咧，咁我哋就可以有個 user， 我哋可以儲多呢個嘢，可能儲翻一啲頭先講可能同 tracking 有關嘅資料啦，又或者可能係佢其他啲 service 嘅 subscription 啊，佢嘅 role 或者等等嗰啲 privilege 等等。咁我哋儲曬呢啲咧，咁我哋就可以喺 WordPress 嗰度攞翻呢啲資料啦，又或者可能其他 application 嗰度去 share 翻呢啲資料都可以嘅。咁同埋咧，頭先我即係回翻我一開頭講好重要嗰個 security 嗰樣嘢啦。咁當我哋咧即係假設如果我哋個網站比較大啲嘅時候，係好多人 log in， 咁我哋好重要嘅一個功能咧就係、是，我哋可能有啲 custom service 嘅喎，因為可能個客會揾我哋話，喂，我 log in 唔到喎，我嘅 account 有問題喎，等等。咁如果我哋仲係靠呢個WordPress 最簡單嘅 user management 咧，咁可能就唔係好夠啦。 咁所以我哋啲 platform 咧，亦都會有一個比較齊全啲嘅 user management 嘅地方嘅。咁呢度咧就見到啦，我咧就揾咗我自己 account 啦。咁我哋咧嗰啲 CS 啊，或者我哋其他 admin 嘅同事咧，就可以咧喺呢個界面裏邊咧，就睇到個 user 嘅設定啦 ，remove user anonymous user 呢個 anonymous user 都好重要一個功能嚟嘅，就因為咧。而家我哋好多時候啲 app 啊，如果我哋係大家知道上架嘅話咧，可能就需要有個 user account deletion 嘅功能啦。咁但係你 user account deletion 嘅話咧，你有可能唔想即係delete 曬佢所有嘅一啲資料，可能你有其他嘅情況會用到啦。咁我哋咧就可以用一個 anonymous user， 你就將佢嘅個人資料咧就全部刪除曬，就剩翻個即係少少嘅 account 喺度 ，keep 翻個 record 喺度都可以。當然亦都可以最盡可以 remove 個 user 啦。咁但係頭先講翻 security 嗰度咧。咁就係、亦都係我哋呢啲 platform 好好用嘅一個地方咧，就係、我哋可以喺度咧喺睇曬個 user 嘅一啲 session 啦，我哋可以隨時去 terminate 佢嘅 session 去控制到，即係如果 user 佢話喂我好似俾人哋hack 咗，我係咪俾人 lock in 咗其他地方啊？咁我哋 support 佢嘅時候咧，我哋都可以喺呢啲 platform， 即係喺呢個 admin portal 裏邊咧，就睇得一清二楚係發生緊咩事嘅。咁當然都可以一次過 terminate 曬佢所有嘅 session 啦。咁就呢度我估咧就簡單嘅介紹咧就係呢度啦。咁就翻翻去今日嗰、那個個 talk 嗰度先。好。咁就咁講咗咁多點樣 integrate 啊，同埋 showcase 咗一啲功能之後咧，咁我都即係要講翻少少即係一啲即係 pitch 嘅嘢啦，就係話啊，咁點解咁值得用呢啲咁嘅platform 或 enable passwordless 啊，或者係 WhatsApp 嘅即係 OTP 嘅 login 咧？最緊要咧，我哋都係睇緊咧係點樣可以令到啲 user 容易啲去 sign up conversion 啫，即係話點樣可以將佢登記成我哋 user 嘅阻力係減到最低最低咧？咁我哋就可以唔需要咁第一就梗係唔需要搞密碼嗰啲嘢啦。咁所以咧，我哋就係可以用到頭先我講嗰啲功能，例如咧，我哋係可以用呢個 email 加 message link 啦，又或者頭先我即係 show 俾大家睇嘅電話號碼加 WhatsApp 等等。咁有咗呢啲嘢之後咧，咁我哋就唔需要擔心咧，佢係會要突然間又要開多個密碼，又要開多個 account， 咁就令到佢咧係 sign up 嘅過程咧係會最順暢啦。咁有咗呢啲咁嘅即係 off 嘅 service 之後咧，咁其實係都可以即係 highlight 翻幾大嘅功能俾大家睇啦。第一就係、我哋頭先個 platform 咧，我哋即係個 user admin portal 咧。都俾大家睇到咧，就係我哋可以睇到好多一啲 user 嘅 admin 嘅情況啦。我頭先冇機會俾大家睇嘅，可能我啲 log 啊，我可能可以 set 啲 rate limit 等等啦。另外咧，如果當我哋嘅系統去到比較複雜啲，我哋係特別咧係話啊，我哋 off 嘅要求可能就話，咦我哋要 2FA， 我哋係要佢個有其他嘅限制，咁我哋又可以做到啦。又或者咧，當我哋係去到有一個位話，咦，當佢做某啲步驟，例如佢改自己嘅 payment method。又或者咧，佢可能係要加某啲嘢，佢改 password 等等啦，即係做一啲 critical transaction 咧，我哋呢啲 platform 咧亦都可以俾大家做一個 re-off 啦，即係話當佢做某啲嘢嘅時候咧，佢要再 authenticate 一次，咁我 make sure 咧就係即係個 security 會更加高啦。咁啊最後啦，就係、當我哋咧係有啲 platform， 我哋已經係儲曬啲 user 嗰啲 sign up 啊，我哋有啲 analytics 資料咧，咁嗰個方面大家 integrate 其他嘅一啲 CDP 啊或者啲 marketing 嘅地方啦。咁因為咧頭先我都介紹咗，因為我係 tech 嘅 background 啦，咁所以我都想好快咁同大家 show 嘅，咁 technical 背後係發生緊咩事呢咁樣。咁其實咧呢度個 show 俾大家睇咧，就係話當個 user 咧，我哋平時我哋就咁去 log in WordPress 嘅時候咧，咁我就直接同個 WordPress 去建立嗰、那個log 俾個 password 佢啦，佢就話知道哦你係某某 user 啦咁樣。咁但當我哋用頭先 off gear 嘅時候，其實背後發生緊咩事呢？其實背後發生緊咧係兩個 authentication 嘅，即係話咧我哋咧 user。去到 WordPress 就話我要 login 啊咁樣，佢就話哦咁你去 off gear 啦，咁之後咧我就會去頭先大家見到咧，我就 off gear 我就打我嘅電話號碼，之後打我個 WhatsApp OTP 啦，之後咧 off gear 咧就話哦呢、這個 user authenticate 咗啦，咁我同 off gear 之間就 off 咗啦，之後我咧就會再 off gear 咧就會再通知翻 WordPress 就話啊呢、這個 user 咧我 authenticate 咗，之後咧其實 WordPress 咧會同我咧都係一個 login 咗嘅關係，都係會 authenticate 嘅。呢度咧其實係翻返去頭先我講咧，有個特別啲嘅地方咧，就係當我哋用呢啲方法嘅時候咧，其實有兩個 user account 嘅。第一咧就係我同 off gear 之間咧都會有一個 user account 啦。第二咧就會自動地咧，我同 WordPress 之間咧都有一個 user account 喺度嘅。咁呢個咧就係會即係純粹係 look 咧就係會有啲叫做啲 attribute。如果你想升嘅話咧，咁可能就會有多少少嘅 integration 啦。 同埋咧，當我哋 stop 咗個 user， 即係話例如咧，我哋係同 Offgear 嗰度，我哋 disable 咗個 user， 即係話佢已經我個 account 有問題喎，好似俾人 hack 咗，我要 disable 佢。咁可能咧喺 WordPress 嗰度咧，我哋就要做多少功夫咧，先至可以令到個 user 都自動去log out 咗嘅，因為咧佢係兩個 session 嚟嘅。當個 user 如果冇自己喺 WordPress 度 log out 咗 log in 咧，咁可能咧都係仲係 maintain 咗 user 同 WordPress 之間 off 咗嘅關係嘅。咁另外啦，就今日時間有限咧，咁我就本來咧就想 show 埋嗰個我哋 pass key 嗰個功能，咁就撳有少少情況咧就撳唔到住，咁但係都好快咧就即係話翻俾大家聽啦，就係、是、咁我哋 Offgear 咧其實而家咧都已經 support 埋 pass key， 咁 pass key 係因為咩咧？其實咧個意思咧就係可以將我哋嗰、那個一個 token 咧就類似就儲咗喺我哋嘅電話啦，或者手機啦，或者電腦嗰度。咁就唔再需要咧，就係佢再用密碼啦，又或者係頭先講嗰啲 OTP 啊等等。咁個意思咧就係 tie in 咗喺一個 physical 嘅 device 嗰度做嗰個 authentication 嘅。咁個好處咧就係當我哋 enable 咗呢樣嘢咧，個 user 咧就連頭先講嗰啲咩打 OTP 啊、打 password 啊等等嗰啲都全部都唔再需要做噶啦。咁呢張圖咧其實係即係簡單 show 咗嗰、那個即係 pass key 嗰個概念啦，就有啲因為咧。這個因為之前我同我同事 share 嘅時候咧，可能大家咧對一啲尤其聽呢啲 off 咧，好多 keyword 咧都可能唔知究竟係咩嚟㗎，好亂咧。咁所以趁呢、這個呢張圖又好快咧，即係講翻少少概念嘅啫。但係咧，可能大家成日聽到嗰個 fiddle 啦，就其實就因為有啲人可能話咩 fiddle standard 啊咁樣，其實就錯嘅，就冇呢樣嘢嘅。fiddle 咧其實就係一個一個組織嚟㗎啦，佢就負責定一啲關於 authentication 嘅 standard。咁之後咧，我哋頭先講話 off key 啊 ，sorry pass key 啊，又或者我哋平時。用好多 biometric 等等嗰啲咧，我哋就有叫做 Fiddle 2嘅 standard 啦。咁之後我哋 Offgear 咧，其實就會用一個叫做 Web Off 咁嘅 standard 咧，就可以做到同個手機嘅 biometric 啦，又或者我哋啲 pass key， 或者大家如果再複雜啲咧，用嗰啲手即係 USB key 等等嗰啲咧，咁都會用呢一個 Web Off 嘅等等嘅 standard 咧，就可以做嗰、那個connection 嘅。咁就我今日咧個 sharing 咧，其實就係咁多，咁就。多謝大家，咁就睇下大家有冇咩問題啦。咁同埋另外咧，我呢度都有個 Offgear 嘅 link 啦。咁同埋我哋 Offgear 本身其實都係 open source 嘅。咁所以如果有興趣咧，都可以去大我哋個 GitHub 嗰度睇下咧。咁就你如果中意可以自己 host 啦。咁如果唔係嘅話咧，其實喺我哋 Offgear 度都有啲即係 developer 嘅 free 嘅 free tier 咧，其實可能好似千幾二千個人其實都可以免費用嘅。咁可以歡迎大家咧就去登記試下，咁就可以 integrate 翻落自己嘅 WordPress website 嗰度。多謝。